Thank you. Good morning to all of us. My fellow servants of the people of Pangasinan, ladies and gentlemen, the 31st governor of the province of Pangasinan, Governor Ramon Mon Guico III.
Thank you, our incoming provincial administrator, Melissa Pataki. Good morning to all of us. Magandang umaga po sa ating lahat, mga minamahal po nating mga kasama sa sangguniang panlalawigan ng ating lalawigan ng Pangasinan, mga board members headed by our presiding officer, Vice Governor Mark Ronald Lambino, sa lahat po ng mga kawani ng ating provincial government, magandang umaga po sa ating lahat. Good morning. It's an honor to join you today in this flag-raising ceremonies. I haven't had the chance to be in such a ceremony. Being mayor of Binalonan for 3 terms, it's been 3 years that I have not joined any of this, except for one in when we sponsored the flag-raising ceremony in Congress. But it's an honor and privilege to see all of you today. I know that there are more of us employees who are deployed in the various offices of the province in the different locations of our province. So, let's. The weather has cooperated. I don't know how much time I have to give you a lecture. Okay lang ba mag-lecture? No, I will not do that. No? But the weather has cooperated, so I think we are in a more comfortable situation right now. But number one, may I ask of all of us to shrug off any dust of politics. Tanggalin po natin ang any notion and sense of politics, because we would like to roll up our sleeves and get down to work. No? Formal ako ngayon, pero naka-rubber shoes ako. So it means that we would like to get things going. We would like to work hard in order to achieve our province's vision, mission, and goals. So I ask each and every one of you, I know that transition is always, there's always fear of getting kicked out, ostracized in an urban organization as big as the provincial government. But rest assured that you have a governor who is very much rational, who is very much compassionate, very much considerate, but of course, do not break my trust. Because once you have broken anybody's trust, it will forever be a, kumbaga, lamat na po yun, panghabang buhay. You can always forgive, but it's very, very difficult to forget, right? No? Tao lamang po tayo. So, fear not if you have not done any physical harm to any of the people within our organization, in our province. Fear not if you are loyal to the institution. First and foremost, may I ask of you to adhere to what we have just recited a while ago, yung ating panunumpa bilang mga public servants. Let us be loyal first and foremost to our province, to our government, to the organization in which we belong. Yan lang po ang aking hinihingi. Of course, please expect that there will be a lot of changes, but rest assured that all of these changes that are to be implemented will be for the betterment and will be for the good of our beloved province. I'd like to take this opportunity andito na rin po tayo lahat. So I can give you a glimpse of my management style. I have been a manager for a very long time. I have managed a school, some schools. I have established some schools, some organizations, both private and public. I've been an entrepreneur. I've been a pilot. I have been a mayor, vice mayor, a congressman. So with all those experiences, I carry with me. I think I have been equipped with enough tool to somehow lead the province to our desired vision. So una-una po, number one, it's management by objective. Number one, kailangan if we have set an objective, no matter what, we should work to achieve those objectives and those goals. And I don't care, no, if you work beyond your required working hours, what's important is that we get our objectives done. No, makuha natin yung dapat na objective natin. Secondly, I think I am an advocate of people empowerment. Remember in my inaugural speech, sinabi ko, all of us humans, we are never perfect. We have not been created like God. We are never gods. We are never demigods. We are just mortals who are given this chance of life, who are given these opportunities. Maximize those opportunities. Yet, we always remember that we need people around us to complement those weaknesses. Do you agree? No? I think I could say that I have been successful in my own endeavors because I believe in the power of human resource. So what needs to be done with us workers? Number one, we should set the right values and principles on how we should run our organization, on how we should run or live our own lives, on how we should belong to this big machine, the organization of the province. Kailangan we should abide by principles that would not step onto others' principles. We should be respectful of one another. No? As an advocate of empowerment, people empowerment, I believe in competence building. I believe so much in the talent of people. No? We are not created na bobo. All of us, we have our own God-given talent and we should discover that. And make it known also to your heads and to your leaders that, hey, I have this talent and I'm willing to work with you for the betterment of our beloved organization. So for those who know that you are talented, for those of you who want to shine, I think all the transition events are always good opportunities for us to let our bosses know that, hey, I am here. Remember when I saw the number of workers and employees within the provincial government, we are numbering more than 6,000. So it's really hard to identify and to know who are the talented ones among those more than 6,000 employees of our provincial government if you don't come out and let the whole world know that there is a name such as this and who has a talent for singing, for dancing, or whatever. So come out, let your talents be known. No, this is, I think, your chance to shine. But what are the important parameters? You should be first and foremost loyal to the institution. Okay ba yun? Tama? There will be a new vision for the province. Campaign promises that we should work hard to achieve. These are not personal promises for gains of personal interest. These are promises most especially given and said because we care and love for, we care and love our dear province of Pangasinan. So, number three, or number four, communication is important. When I was mayor of Binalonan, some of our barangays, although I did not fully agree, they passed an anti-chismis ordinance. No? Before the term or the name Marites was coined, in my hometown, they already identified a plague in our community, in our family, even in a small organization. No, they passed an anti-chismes ordinance, anti-marites and marisol ordinance. So, communication is very important. Many as you are thousands, but this time we are finding ways on how to efficiently manage our organization. Our budget team has informed us that there will be, you know, a significant decrease of our annual budget. So we have to plan together with the department heads, together with our very loyal workers of our province, of course, in cooperation with the Sangguniang Palalawigan, on how we can pass a budget that would answer the needs of our province for the next year, at the same time in consideration of managing and running a very effective and efficient organization. So, no, wala po sanang mga chismis, because dyan po nagsisimula ang away-away. No? Sino bang chismoso sa inyo? Lahat tayo, in one way or another, we have become marites in our own rights. But please, let's avoid those. No, I am a person who likes to communicate openly. No, kailangan sabihin nyo, huwag yung puro assumption. Pag may ginawang isang bagay, uy, ganito nang ginawa niya. No, it has to be validated. Everything that you should believe should first come from me, first and foremost, my mouth. No, you hear my voice, my actuations, or most importantly, it should be in black and white. If there's no black and white, no, these are just presumptions and assumptions. So, let's communicate openly. My office is open, but of course, I cannot accommodate all of you. Discarte nyo na lang siguro yan. No, again, I'm a believer of empowerment. I am believer of talent. I do not know all of you. Ako po ang baguhan dito. Many of you have served so many governors in your career. So kami po'y dumadaan lang dito. No, but many of you have been here for the last so many years. And you have encountered the different management styles of all the governors that have served the provincial capital. So, it's your time to shine. If you have what it takes, let us know. If you know you have the talent and you can contribute to better our province, let us know. Communicate it openly. So, wag po kayong mag-alala. This week, no, life goes on. Trabaho po tayo. You need not worry about anything. If you have not hurt anybody, if you have not compromised the values of our institution, if you have not hurt anybody, no? If you have not compromised your values, you need not worry about anything. So, communication, validate that first. And also, I am a believer of proper planning. Kailangan planuhin natin ng maayos ang pagpapatakbo ng ating minamahal na probinsya. So, Vice Governor Mark Lambino, to all our board members, our beloved department heads and employees of the provincial government of Pangasinan, Good morning, and I look forward to working with you for the next 3 years to achieve a better Pangasinan. God bless us all.
Maraming salamat. Once again, let's give a warm round of applause to Honorable Governor Ramon Mon Guico III. At this point, we shall now have one of the first official photo with our governor and Sangguniang Panlalawigan members. Pwede po, alisin muna natin saglit ang ating mga mask. For the first official photo with our Governor Mon-Mon Guico III, Vice Governor Mark Ronald Lambino, and the rest of the Sangguniang Panlalawigan members and our provincial employees. Alright, there you go. Palakpakan po natin ang ating mga sarili. That ends our flag raising ceremony for this week. Have a blessed and fruitful week ahead. Maraming salamat po.